In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this really unique facade design in Revit by utilizing groups. This is going to allow us to automate part of the process, making everything a bit easier. Now, I'm going to be showing you everything step by step from beginning to finish. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about mastering Revit, we are an Autodesk authorized training center and we offer over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. I have just created kind of a fake building for this. We have 7 levels and we have floors on each one and we have walls, and this is just what we're going to use as a starting point. Now the first balcony I'm just going to build here in a corner. So let's open up level 1. I'm going to zoom in a little bit like that. Then I'm going to go here to the wall tool and let's pick out a wall. I'm going to just go with the 200 millimeter wall, just like that. I'm going to go here to the edge and go out by about, let's go with 3000 millimeters. Hit the escape key a couple of times. And also I'm just going to use the align tool to align it here. The next step is going to be to select this wall, and I'm just going to copy it off to the side by 4000 millimeters, just like that. Now let's jump into the 3D view, see what we have. I'm just going to select these two and let's make them a bit lower. So I'm just going to make them 3000 millimeters, just like that. Now let's add a floor. So go back into level 1. I'm going to go here to architecture and then go to floor. For this, I'm going to use a 200 millimeter floor, which we don't have. So I'm just going to go with 300, go to edit type, go to duplicate, and then just call this one the 200 millimeter generic. Go to structure and change this to 200 millimeter, just like so. And now we have a new floor type. So let's go to rectangle, and I'm just going to place it like this underneath these two walls. Hit the escape key a couple of times and then hit finish. Now let's open up the elevation view. So here I have this elevation, so I'm just going to open that up. Here you can see it's set up to wireframe. It's just going to make it a bit easier to see the floors that are already there, but also you can switch to hidden line and it's going to work pretty much either way. So first I'm just going to select this floor and then I'm going to go here to copy from clipboard, paste, align to selected levels, and then paste it on level 2. Click OK. Now I just want to move it down. So I'm just going to go to copy and then just copy this one down by 600 millimeters. Actually, I need it to be 400. So let's change that. So we have that 200 millimeter gap. Also for these two walls, I'm just going to make them a bit lower. So if I know that this is, let's see. So from the ground, that's 2600. So I can just hold the control key, select these two and make this 2600, just like that. Okay, now let's go to the 3D view and this is what we have. It looks like a cube, which is nice, but it doesn't look exactly like the balcony that we want to create. So to change this, what I'm going to do is just select this floor, go to edit boundary, click here and then make this 1500, just like that, finish. And now let's adjust the walls to fit this. So I'm just going to select this wall, go into edit profile, select it like this, just the two lines, and then move this in to that edge. Remove the constraints, just double check if everything is in the correct place, and it does seem to be. Yes, hit finish. And now this is what we have. Now for the second one, we're just going to repeat that. So just go into that edit mode, just select like this, two of them, grab that button and then move it in. Perfect, remove constraints and there we go, hit finish. And this is what we have right now. Okay, so the next step is going to be to fix these edges up. Obviously, this doesn't look good. It doesn't follow kind of that correct slope. So what I need to do for that is I need to extend the bottom floor a little bit here. So I'm just going to extend it like that, hit finish, Yeah, that should do the job. And now we need to basically cut off a part of this floor on top and part of this floor on the bottom. I'm going to do that by going here to Architecture, going to Component, and then go to Model in Place. Here, I want to search for the generic models. Click OK. Generic model 1, that's fine. Click OK. And now let's go here to Create, go to Void Forms, Void Extrusion, and go to Set Work Plane and use Pick a Plane to pick this plane over here. Now I'm just going to use Pick Lines. I'm going to pick this one and this one and this one and this one and this one. And yeah, that should be it. Then I'm going to hit the Escape key a couple of times, use the Split Element tool and split this line, and then go to Trim and Extend to Corner. And I'm just going to fix this up like so, and then fix this up like so. Perfect. Hit the Escape key a couple of times, hit Finish, and now just extend it to the other side, just like so. Now, this is still just a void, it's not cutting, so we need to go here to Geometry, to Cut Geometry, select the floor on top, and cut. And then select the floor on bottom, find that void, and cut. And this is what we get as the solution. Hit Finish, and there we go. So we have the bottom balcony. Now, this balcony wouldn't be completed without a railing. So we can do, just go here to railing, and then let's go to level 1, zoom in here, go to railing, and then I'm just going to go with the glass railing, and let's place it like so. Hit the Escape key a couple of times, hit Finish, go to the 3D view. Yeah, looks nice. I'm just going to move it a bit, kind of towards the edge, just like that. There we go. Now for the balcony on top, I'm just going to follow the same process. So let's select this, go to our elevation, then go to copy, paste, align to selected levels. That should be level 3. Just like that. And then also let's now lower this. So I'm just going to copy it down. I think we said 400 millimeters. There we go, because we want to keep this gap between the floors. So there we go. Okay, so it should go from here to here. Yeah, and now we can delete this one because we no longer need it. And there we go. And now I'm just going to double click on this one and make it 1500 millimeters, just like so. And now I'm simply going to repeat the process just as we did with the bottom balcony. We're going to be doing the same with the balcony on top. I'm not going to show you everything step by step because you have already seen it, so it doesn't make sense to make it repetitive. And now, moving forward, we just need to add a couple of more things before we can start automating the process of basically plastering these balconies all across the facade. So for that, what I want to do is go to level 1 here, and then I'm just going to go to wall, and then here pick out the storefront, and I'm just going to place it like this with a bit of an offset from each side of the wall, just like so. I'm going to select this and make it 2400 millimeters tall, just like that. Go to the 3D view. Here it is. This is what that looks like. Now I'm just going to go here to copy, paste, align to selected levels, and go to level 2. So we have the glass balcony doors on both of these balconies. And now this is where the magic happens. This is where we start the automation process. So what I'm going to do now is just orbit around a little bit like so, and then just grab everything that's over here. So we have the glass balcony doors, the railing, the walls, and the floors. Then you go here to create group, and I'm just going to call this one balcony 1. Then click OK, and I'm going to do the same thing for the one above. So just orbit around a little bit, grab everything, go to create group, and call this one balcony 2. Click OK, and there we go. Now we have created these two as groups. So now if I go to the project browser and scroll down, you'll notice that here under groups, we now have two model groups, the balcony 1 and balcony 2. So that's important. And yeah, now let's actually apply this across the entire facade. So for that, what I'm going to do first is go to Architecture, then go to Work Plane, Set Work Plane, use Pick a Plane, and then select this wall face, just like so. And now we should be able to start moving things around. So I'm just going to select the group on the bottom, go to the south elevation here, and then let's just go here to copy, unconstrain it and go from here all the way up here, just like that. And then also I can move it up here as well, just like so. Then I'm going to select this one, go again to copy, unconstrain it, go from there, go up to here, and then again unconstrain it and go up to here. Perfect. The next step is going to be to move this off to the side. So I'm just going to select the bottom ones. So just like this, the bottom, what is this, 5, and then go to copy, and I'm just going to copy it from here and unconstrain it and paste it here, just like that. Perfect. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Okay, they could be a little bit more spread out, so I'm just going to hold the control key, select these 5, just like that, and then just use the arrow keys to move them away from this one. Yeah, I think this should be enough. Perfect. Go to the 3D view. This is what we have. And now this one, I'm just going to delete because we don't need one there at the bottom. This should just be on the upper floors, and then on the bottom we can have something else. Now we need to select all of these groups, so just like that. And then once we have that, let's go to the elevation here, go to copy, and then go again. I'm going to go from perhaps something like this, and then I'm just going to copy it off to the side like so. And then let's see what that looks like. Okay, it looks perfect. Copy it here. There we go. Looks really, really good. Now, because it looks like I made this building a bit too large, I can just move this wall in to fit the whole thing a little bit better. And there we go. Looks quite nice. There we go. As you can see, this was done really quickly and really easily. As soon as you have the two balconies, plastering them around is going to be really, really easy. Now, one more thing that I would like to do is I would like to make sure that the materials are set up correctly so everything looks nice. So I'm just going to use the tab key to tab into this wall, go into edit type, go to structure, edit, and then here just find a brick material that's going to fit our design. So let's search for brick. Okay, I found the one that I like, so I'm just going to load that one in, hit apply, okay. And then here, what they'll do is I'm just going to copy this material name. Control C to copy, there we go, okay. Apply, okay, perfect. Then I'm going to use the tab key to select one of the floors, go into edit type, structure, edit, and then here I'm just going to paste that material name and it's just going to keep that name. Click okay. Apply. Okay, perfect. And now let's take a look at what does this look like in realistic with shadows. And yeah, turn on the shadows. And as you can see, it looks really, really beautiful. So we have created quite a unique and beautiful facade design rather quickly. Thank you for watching. If you would like to get this Revit project file, make sure to go to my Patreon page. So the link will be up in the cards above and also down in the description of this video. That's where I have all of my Revit project files at one place.